Hi, I'm Rowan from Vantage Admissions, and in this video, we're going to talk about the past papers you should be completing if you're preparing for the ESAT. If you're new to the ESAT and would like a more general introduction, do see our earlier video linked in the description. The matter of which past papers to complete can be confusing for ESAT. The exam only started in 2024, and so there are very few official practice resources available. However, to get used to the style of question and to prepare for the challenge ahead, it's important to work through past paper questions from relevant previous exams. Although the ESAT is new, it's really the successor of the NSAA and the ENGAA, two older exams which were previously used by Cambridge. Both of these exams will therefore form an important part of past paper practice, but even this is complicated by the fact that the format of the NSAA and the ENGAA changed over the course of their run from 2016 to 2023. There are other past paper series which may also be of relevance to preparing ESAT candidates, especially the TMUA. Before getting into the details of exactly which past papers to complete, some general advice on the use of past papers when preparing for ESAT. Firstly, don't complete past paper questions arranged by topic, but rather work through full papers. The reason for this is because a huge part of the challenge of ESAT problems is going to be determining what topic a question is really about. And this can be deceptive. For example, in mathematics, a question that looks to be inviting an algebraic approach might really need to be studied graphically. Or a mechanics question that looks like it wants to be handled with force considerations might actually need an energy-based approach. If you're working through questions which have been pre-arranged by topic, you're artificially removing this layer of difficulty. Secondly, try not to rely too heavily on third-party past papers and prioritise the past papers of real exam series such as the NSAA and the ENGAA. This is not to disparage the quality of some of the third-party papers that you can find online, including those supplied by the community, but rather it's the simple observation that the examiners will be looking at the past papers, the real published past papers, for inspiration when setting their questions. Third-party papers will not be as known to the examiners and so are far less likely to be drawn on for inspiration. It's also important not to dip in and out of papers, but to try to work through them with a timed mock in the first instance. Given the intensity of the time pressure on the ESAT, a very large portion of the benefit that you can extract from each paper will come from the experience of a formal timed mock at the start of the process. When working through papers, try to work forwards from older to newer, reflecting the generally increased difficulty of the newer papers, and also therefore saving the most relevant resources for right before the exam. Since you'll be working forward from old to new, it is important to sit down and think very carefully about exactly how many papers you're likely to have time to complete so that you can start from an appropriate paper and work forwards. It's important to be conservative with this estimate. You don't want to, for example, run out of time having left the most recent few papers uncompleted. Finally, it's important to reflect on your performance. Keep detailed notes on how you've done on each paper, the date you completed it, the score on each section, scaled scores if possible, and also notes on any particular difficulties you encountered, subject areas that were perhaps flagged as a weakness, and any general lessons about exam technique that you can extract from that performance. There are some official ESAT past paper resources available on the Pearson VUE website, namely a set of practice papers and a set of specimen papers. Somewhat confusingly, these are different. The practice papers are drawn entirely from past NSAA and ENGAA questions, although they have been specifically selected for their relevance to the modern ESAT. Students who will be working through many NSAA and ENGAA past papers therefore may like to skip this resource. The specimen papers are all original questions, which have been written specifically for the ESAT. And so these provide some of the most realistic preparation resources available. It's therefore recommended to save the specimen papers until very shortly before the exam. The NSAA provides a vital source of past paper practice for all ESAT candidates, regardless of module selection. The NSAA contain two sections, Section 1 and Section 2. Section 1 included parts for mathematics, as well as each of the three sciences, while there was no mathematics on Section 2. Section 1 was multiple choice through the entirety of the run of the NSAA. For the science parts, the specification was essentially identical to that of the modern ESAT, and the mathematics part was very similar to the scope of modern ESAT Mathematics 1. Section 2 is a bit more complicated. Until 2019, the questions were long form, not multiple choice, which somewhat reduces the relevance to the ESAT. However, these questions can still provide a very useful form of enrichment, especially for those candidates anticipating an interview. After 2019, Section 2 moved to a multiple choice format, although the specification was more advanced than that of the ESAT. So some of the questions which were asked could not be set on the modern exam. We will be issuing some guidance on exactly which NSAA Section 2 questions could fall within the scope of the modern ESAT specification. So far, things are very straightforward, but the NSAA does become more complicated when considered in conjunction with the ENGAA. The ENGAA can provide a very useful source of additional past paper practice, especially for those candidates taking at least one of Maths 2 and Physics on the ESAT. The complication is that on each year, there was some overlap between the questions asked on the ENGAA and the questions asked on the NSAA. The ENGAA contained two sections. Section 1, which was entirely multiple choice, was split into a Part A and a Part B. Part A, on basic maths and physics, completely overlapped with questions set on that year's NSAA, and so can be skipped by any candidates who will already be using the NSAA. Part B, on advanced maths and physics, did have some overlap with questions from the NSAA from 2016 to 2019, although there were some new questions. And from 2020 onwards, the Part B ENGAA problems were completely different from those set on the NSAA. The advanced maths problems are very similar to those that you can expect to see on ESAT Mathematics 2 and provide very useful practice for that module. The physics questions were broader in scope than those on ESAT Physics, and so some of the questions may not be entirely relevant to the modern specification. ENGAA Section 2 was different from NSAA from 2016 to 2019, when the ENGAA had a multiple choice format, although requiring justification for the answers to be written by the candidate. From 2020 onwards, the ENGAA Section 2 questions were identical to those set on NSAA Section 2 and so can be skipped. Note that ENGAA Section 2 only covered physics. To take maximal benefit from the NSAA and ENGAA past papers, it's best to use the following process. You should work through the papers from oldest to newest, starting with the oldest paper you will have time to complete. It's best to estimate this conservatively to make sure you do have time to get through to the most recent and therefore most relevant past papers. Regardless of your module selection on the ESAT, all students should begin with NSAA Section 1. Everybody should complete the mathematics section, and you should then also complete any science sections relevant for your ESAT module selection. You then need to decide whether you want to use the NSAA Section 2 problems to bolster your preparation for the science papers, bearing in mind that, as discussed, these are not always multiple choice and may use more advanced material. if you decide to use these, complete all the questions from Section 2 on the NSAA. Students who will be taking Maths 2 and or Physics should then move on to the ENGAA. For Section 1, you can skip Part A since all of these questions overlap with the NSAA. For Part B, Maths 2 students should complete all the mathematics questions, and Physics students may or may not decide to also complete the physics questions in light of the fact they can use more advanced material. Remember that some of the questions from Section 1 Part B will overlap with questions from that year's NSAA, and we have detailed documents available, linked in the description, which list the new questions that you'll want to complete. You then need to decide whether you want to use ENGAA Section 2 to further bolster your physics preparation. Remember that from 2020 onwards, these are identical to the NSAA Section 2 questions and so can be skipped, but the 2016 to 2019 problems can be useful. The TMUA is a vital and often overlooked source of additional past paper practice for students taking Maths 2. The TMUA ran under the old exam administrator from 2016 until 2023, and these past papers are publicly available. There are two papers for TMUA, Paper 1 and Paper 2, each consisting of 20 multiple choice questions. ESAT candidates should skip Paper 2 since it uses lots of ideas from logic which are not relevant. But Paper 1 overlaps very closely with the ESAT Maths 2 specification, and moreover, reports from students suggest that the ESAT Maths 2 questions that have been seen so far align more closely with TMUA Paper 1 problems than, for example, advanced maths problems from the ENGAA. So you definitely shouldn't overlook the TMUA when designing your past paper plan. For students who run out of TMUA questions but want even more maths practice, the MAT, which has been used by Oxford since 1996, is also a great source of extra problems. You should only answer the multiple choice questions, which means the parts of question 1 from 1996 until 2023. Bear in mind that from 1996 until 2006, some of the problems did use more advanced material, such as advanced calculus and compound angle formulae, but from 2007 onwards, the syllabus essentially overlaps perfectly with that of Mathematics 2. It's important to think carefully about the process of completing a past paper to make sure you're extracting maximal benefit. You should always begin with a timed mock. Given that the time pressure on the ESAT is extraordinary, and indeed forms a very large portion of the challenge, you will be missing a huge part of the benefit if you skip this step. Don't worry if at first your timed mocks aren't going very well, and when you're completing only part of a past paper, for example, because you're doing ENGAA and have already completed some of those questions on the NSAA, you should adjust the time of your mock to account for the proportions of the questions which you will actually be completing. After your timed mock, you should work through the remaining questions without time constraints. It's really important not to move on from this stage too quickly. It's tempting to feel that time is being wasted if you spend a long time on one problem without successfully answering it. But if you're experimenting with your ideas on the problem, even if they're not succeeding, you're watching why they're not working, how they're not working, and you're sharpening your problem-solving instincts. So even when it feels like you're not making progress, this is a vital part of the training. Eventually, you'll need to move on and look at some solutions, at which stage you should mark your work and thoroughly review the problems that you weren't able to complete. Don't satisfy yourself just with being able to follow the steps of someone else's solution, but emphasize the thought process, the narrative, and where the ideas are really coming from, so that you can use those ideas, even if they're dressed up differently, in future papers. We've conveniently collected all the relevant past papers on our website, linked in the description. This includes our own answer keys for the older MAT multiple choice problems, for which official solutions aren't available. We also provide conversion charts for the NSAA and the ENGAA papers, so that you can convert your raw score to a scaled score from 1.0 to 9.0. This can be especially helpful for tracking your progress in light of the varying difficulty between the years. If you're looking for more intensive support with past papers, within our ESAT preparation program, we also include video and booklet solutions for all past papers on the relevant exam series, with an emphasis on narrative and thought process. I hope you found this helpful. If you're interested in more videos on the ESAT, including preparation advice and some technical maths and physics content, do remember to subscribe. And thanks for watching.